Show my face.
Thank you. And we're here back on the E3 Stage 1 live show here at GameSpot. It's a massive booth. You guys will get a look at it at some point later on. But for now, we're talking Watch Dogs. I'm here with Dominic and Jonathan from Ubisoft. Guys, welcome to the stage.
Thank you.
Yeah, I can't stretch that far and do a handshake. Watch Dogs, of course, made a huge splash last year at E3. It was the announcement, ended Ubisoft's press conference with a bang. Everyone was all agog over it. And this year, you guys are coming in. People know about your game, but you're still got new stuff to show. People are still very excited about it. How did it feel yesterday on stage at Ubisoft?
It was good. It was good to have a chance to show more about the game. This year we're showing some multiplayer, we're showing more of what we're doing with mobile devices, and most importantly we're showing a lot more stuff that Aiden can do in the game. So it was good to have a chance to show more of the game.
Excellent, and we're going to be taking a look at that press conference demo and sort of talking our way through it and asking questions. And folks, as always, send questions to hashtag GameSpotE3 on Twitter, or join us in the twitch.tv/GameSpotChat, or comment on GameSpot.com to get your questions asked of these fine gentlemen here about Watch Dogs. My question is, you mentioned mobile, and that was something we saw towards the end. Actually, let's wait. We'll talk about that towards the end of the demo, but when we see it in action. But the trailer you guys released for Aiden, he's basically busting up a human trafficking ring in downtown Chicago. You guys are not shying away from any kind of underbelly, any kind of seedy situation here in Watch Dogs, are you?
No, we're not. Like, actually, it's important for us to really dig in the gutter of a city, like, not just, like, show the surface of it. Like, since Aiden have access to everything, it makes sense that he should be able to dig into a world that not everybody have access to.
No one can hide from Aiden.
Exactly. So I think it makes something new and different and fresh to explore. Of course, that's not the only elements we have. Like, we do have those dark places, but a city is made of a bunch of different tones, so we want to make sure we cover it all.
Sure. And I think nothing exemplifies that more than just, like, walking down the street in Watch Dogs and, like, you know, sort of spying on everyone, seeing the factoids of them come up and the bank account information and just the breadth of citizenry. You know, it gives you guys sort of an extra storytelling tool to flesh out this version of Chicago, because, you know, not all video games take on a real city to try to bring that to life. How is that? I mean, have you guys been to Chicago a lot recently? How has that been for you to build this virtual city?
Yeah, it's been obviously a lot of going there and taking photos and visiting all sorts of neighborhoods.
And peeping over people's emails and hacking their debit. No, not that far.
But we actually recorded all of our characters and all of the voices for the civilians in Chicago, working with actors that are from Chicago.
Trying to
research, make our research as rooted in the city as we can.
Uh-huh.
The idea being maybe a little bit because we're lazy, because actually, it's easier to create something that feels right if you base it on real things.
If you have something to just compare it to. Yeah. Yep, that looks cool.
Instead of just dreaming it up
just
all the time.
Pulling it all from your mind. No, you just have to pull the really dark stuff that's below the surface from your mind, which gives me a little insight into you two and their whole development scene there at Watch Dogs. All right, let's fire up the gameplay and take a look at what you guys showed off yesterday. This is Aiden showing that despite the fact that he seems a little bit like a lone wolf, is not a guy without friends, without connections.
It's important for us to make sure that you have connection and characters to bound with, like, right? Like, it's another way of getting into a different perspective of a city. Like, it's cool to monitor people and get into other people's lives, but you need also to get people who are expert in their own fields to understand that. T-Bone, the guy you have to save, is a pretty smart fellow. He looks quite atypical for a special engineer actor kind of guy, but he knows a lot about computers, a lot more than Aiden, actually, in certain extent. So he does need his skills around. So when T-Bone ends up in trouble because he basically entered an apartment to steal important information, he tripped to the alarm, and now fixers are coming his way to kill him. So Aiden have all the interest in the world of making sure that he keep that guy alive.
And he wants to get there. Now, this is something that, you know, we've seen a bunch of driving games come out in the, you know, with the whole next-gen launch. Driving games are something that come out a lot, but not a lot of those games reward driving safely. But in Watch Dogs, I mean, you know, he blew through a stop sign there, but you're not tearing around the city pell-mell. There is value in going undetected.
There's definitely value going undetected. I think undetected is the key word here. Like right now in the demo, as we see, Aiden is able to hide behind a van and just literally stop the engine and hides in his car. So you don't need to respect like all signs in the city, but when the cops are like, you know, like having a quarantine around searching for Aiden Pierce, you definitely have to be smart and outsmart them. So it brings a little bit of a more realistic feel to it, where you don't always have to press the pedal to the metal to solve the problem with cops. You can go subtle and make it more interesting. Unless you get tagged
by the cops, and then you've got to make a quick getaway. And so, right near here, we see what kind of alert feedback is the player getting on the UI? I mean, you've got the mini map, but otherwise it's a pretty minimal heads up display here. You guys are aiming for with Watch Dogs. What kind of cues is the player getting?
Well, we have a pretty basic like detection system in terms of HUD. Like, we want to make it simple and clear. So anytime an enemy detects you, you have a little triangle that comes on with a little timer indicator that tells you like when they're going to be able to actually react to it. So that's true for choppers, for cops wandering around with lights in the night searching for you, or any people in stealth anyway. So we want to make it as straightforward as possible to make sure that we never create like hiccups or different signs and feedback for different kind of gameplay. So people will not get lost from one experience to the other.
So we were talking a little bit earlier about the driving and, you know, how the car is not just a tool for going at top speed from point A to point B. You're sort of varying. It's a variety of ways you want to use that tool. Now here's another scene where we see Aiden using his tools, and this, you're basically just a disembodied camera, but you're still ordering people around.
Yeah, you're still around, right? Yeah, like Aiden is in a staircase right beside this place, but he's projecting his ability to hack through hacking through cameras. So basically it's line of sight based. Now he's using the camera, he's able to hack and also to inform T-Bone of when he can move from cover to cover and actually which cover to move to. So he's hinting to his buddy, go there, and how to move around to avoid detection. But at any time I can pull back into my character and just go up there and start shooting if I want to also.
And just, you know what? This stealth thing isn't working out. These guys are causing me trouble. Time to take them all out. And, you know, but that also comes with it some risks, right? Because it puts T-Bone in danger, presumably.
Yeah, the idea here is to try and keep T-Bone alive, obviously. But we want to support, you know, different player styles. I'm the kind of guy who'll go up there, guns blazing, and try to protect T-Bone. Maybe I'll tell him, go over there, you know, hide over in that cover, and then I'll go in guns blazing. But, you know, a lot of guys on the team want to do things in a non-lethal way and try to stealth their way through or help T-Bone stealth his way through in this case.
Now, what would happen if T-Bone did die in that mission?
In that mission, if he dies, like, it's pretty much mission over. Like, that's the point of the objective in that mission, to save him and make sure he survived.
And so you'd be busted back to the start of that mission, give it another shot?
Yeah.
No permadeath for T-Bone, and you have to live in a world without T-Bone? Thank goodness, who would want to live in a world without T-Bone? All right, we're looking at some questions off Twitch. Josh Cudby wondering about Aiden Pierce, and, you know, he's got his trench coat, his baseball cap, sort of incognito style. Is there going to be any kind of customization for the character in terms of, like, what, you know, maybe you could want to get a black jacket or a blue baseball cap? You want to be a Cubs fan?
Yeah, so there are a form of customization. You will be able to have variety in his look, but we didn't want to go with a full like makeup type of thing where you try to hide your identity. We like to have a character that's strong visually, that flows in his animation, that's cool to play and impersonate. But at the same time, we're giving flexibility. So if you want to go to the store and customize a little bit, some of those things, you can do it too.
And if you want to go for a sweet boat ride, you can also do that. Of course, Chicago on the shores of Lake Michigan, one of the Great Lakes. I think it's Lake Michigan. And crisscrossed by these canals, just one of the many forms of transit Aiden can take advantage of. Can this dude fly a helicopter, by the way, at all? Is he a helicopter pilot? No? All right, that's fair. Besides, flying a helicopter in a city, come on, that's super hard. Now I've got a question from Tom Servo in the Twitch chat wondering about multi-platform sort of capabilities. I mean, Watch Dogs is slated to come to the Wii U, and it seems like in a game that's focused on smartphone usage that tablet is just a natural fit for a lot of gameplay functionality. Can you guys talk a little bit about how you're taking advantage of that platform's unique assets?
Well, we definitely have like certain elements for the tablets right now, but like it's not going to be exactly the same as the companion that we've shown right now. Like the Benjamin's been built with the idea that you can actually use it like both in aside your plant or friend, but also outside. Like it's something you can do in real time, whether you're on the bus or anything like that. So we have other elements that are more natural for the Wii U to fit on in there, like with the interface and the controls and everything.
All right. Now we're talking about tablets and in-game, out of the game. I've got this tablet here. I'm checking the questions in the GameSpot comments. I'm also checking them on Twitter. And one of the questions from Arno Kennis is wondering about using a tablet to complement in-game play. We heard a little bit about that at the end of the demo, but let's get into that. How does a player with a smartphone or a tablet affect the player's game who's playing Watch Dogs on their console?
Yeah, well, let's take what happened in the demo as an example. So the player was in trouble. He had, you know, very high heat level. The cops were going to go back on him.
Helicopter spotlight
was
on him.
Yeah, so he calls for help. So basically, he's the one who called for help, and that was going to trigger a call to all of his friends. And so his friends can be in the living room with him, but they can be also in their own houses far away. So they're going to get a notification, and if they want, they can join in at that point. And in that case, they can help him. They can support him from that view, from a top-down view, controlling the city, being able to hack all the same hacks that Aiden can do, and even more powerful
traffic
ones.
Traffic lights, those bollards that come up to block intersections.
He actually hacked that chopper, directly hacked the chopper. The guy had to go away. So those kinds of things.
No kidding.
So this is a context where a friend is helping you, but we're also starting to show how you can compete. So we have some very specific context. If you want to compete with one of your buddies, or even with a stranger, you can send out a challenge, and they will play from their mobiles, and you will be playing from the consoles, and they will try to stop you from achieving a certain set of goals, hacking in the city, and also controlling all of the police forces, so they can dispatch cops after you, try to find your location, scanning around the city with the surveillance system. So it's pretty intricate way to play the game. It's a very full-on mode that we have.
A full-on mode to basically mess with your buddy, right? And try to shut him down. Now, let's put that in the context of I'm playing through my campaign. You know, I choose a menu option. I say, all right, I want these multiplayer experiences to be available. I want that to be able to happen. What happens if my buddy is successful and I smash my car and the cops come down and they bust me?
Yeah, we're going to make that safe in the sense that we're going to deal that the specific competitive mode, we're going to make it a bubble in the experience. So, okay. I mean, if you die, you'll just respawn and you can go on with your adventure as Aiden. So we won't have you suffer long-term consequences. It's really a mode for fun with people, with friends, a way of connecting. And it is really fun, actually, and we don't want it to, you know, intersect with the experience of the game. But if he comes and helps you, you still move on your quest, though. So that's two different things.
And does to the victor go the spoils? Are there any benefits that you're getting in game from, you know, either from thwarting your friend or from helping him out or from escaping? Like, what are you getting?
There's progression in there. There's also a bunch of different things you can share back with the players also on the console. So you can get extra element that you can give to other players. You can also progress. You have a bit more tools in there. So there's all of that that's in there to make sure that the players enjoy this experience.
Cool. I'm looking at the Twitch chat and they're wondering about, you know, that's a glimpse at a multiplayer experience. And of course, the theme of this year's E3 is the blending of single player and multiplayer. Are there any other multiplayer experiences in Watch Dogs?
A hearty head shake.
Let's talk a little. Can we talk a little bit about those?
Of course, yeah, we can. Now we can.
Now you can.
Last year we teased it. At the end of our demo, we showed another player in there, but we just teased it. We're actually demoing it. We basically have players crossing path in the same. Oops, am I losing? No. Okay. Another player is trying to hack Aiden Pierce. So we have another player coming into the middle of of his adventure, trying to hack into Aiden.
That's right. I remember that, Caesar. Yeah.
And then you have to either try and find where he is and try to catch him back. So we have that demoing at the booth right now.
Okay. Yeah. So that's sort of a one-on-one player invasion kind of tactic. Is there any just straight up 12 Aiden Pierces versus 12 Aiden Pierces, everybody running and shooting up the Chicago streets?
There is just one Aiden Pierce. But yes, we do have more full-on multiplayer contacts also, but we're not talking about them now. Yet.
Okay, steadily more and more multiplayer information we're going to squeeze out of you guys. I like it. And, you know, in terms of the multi-platform play, again, Rob James on Twitter wondering, is there any kind of cross-platform play, you know, let's do the rundown. Watch Dogs is available on what systems? Will be available on what systems?
PS3, PS4, Xbox 360, Xbox on.
Okay, so you guys are covering a lot of bases. Yeah. Is there any crossings? And then, of course, those systems are going to be, you can influence. All right, let me break my question down. Can those systems interact with each other? Any cross-platform play?
Well, you do have cross-platform for any mobile versus any platform, right? So, like, if you have like any sort of Android or Apple tablets or phones, those gameplay can work on against like any kind of other platforms out there.
Any platform.
Exactly.
That was my other question. Excellent. Glad to know that.
But the various platforms cannot be connected together.
Sure.
Cannot be together.
Okay. Cool. Because, oh, it's so satisfying to get answers out of you guys after last year. all right. So, Watch Dogs. You know, this is a world that is dark. Has darkness, I guess we should say. And this is an interesting balancing act you guys are doing, where you're showing, you know, the gritty, terrible, evil side of humanity. You know, you're allowing the player to be the sword of justice, to have Aiden be able to bring people to justice, but you're not necessarily requiring that. Well, there's a little bit of flexibility. You know, Aiden Pierce is not a white knight. He is not unsullied. He is not always fighting for the greater good. How has it been to sort of carve out these different kinds of morality spheres within the game?
Well, that was an important one for us. Like, it's a big deal for us to say he's a vigilante. Like, he's a modern day or real life vigilante. A lot of people have been talking to us, like, for example, why the cops are not his friend or things like that. Well, there's comic books and there's reality. Like, in reality, if you go on to do your own justice in your life, I don't think that the cop's going to be your best friend, at least to a certain extent. So I think it brings this balance where the player can be his own kind of vigilante. Does he want to be ruthless? Then we'll respect that, but we'll put the response that are credible and logical for our world to be significant. So, like, if you are loose cannon going everywhere, the media will talk about you as a loose cannon. The people will watch the media in the game, and then they're going to react accordingly.
Yeah, that guy in Starbucks is going to get really alarmed and go outside and maybe try to make a call.
Exactly. And even when that happens, if you've seen a demo, Aiden is just taking his phone out and destroying it. That's another way for us to say, well, you could shoot him in the face, but if you do that, other people will see it. They all have phones. It's going to escalate like there's no tomorrow.
Yeah.
So I think we're at least inviting the player to consider of the way of playing, like sneaking around, not getting seen by a car. Like, all of those elements are there to make sure that if a player doesn't want to be the kind of vigilante that destroys everything in his path, then he can be that. And it's not for us to judge, like, his experience.
Interesting. Super important question, by the way, very serious, coming in from Consolized. Are there any dogs in Watch Dogs?
No.
There's no dogs.
No dogs. All right, there you go. E3 is over. That's all you guys wanted to know, right? Cool. all right, guys. Watch Dogs. When are you targeting for a release for this game?
Well, we're shipping on November 19th in North America, November 21st in Europe.
November 19th, North America, November 21st on Xbox 360, Xbox One, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, PC, Wii U, and then whatever old tablet you have. That tablet game, is that a free to download? Is that you pay separately to download it on your device?
Or? Right now, our idea is to make it freely available. We might have some aspect where you can progress faster if you want to spend money,
okay. But
that's something that we're just looking at. But the base idea is just to distribute it freely and have as many possible playing it.
And then do you choose, so if I'm a tablet player, do I choose to connect to, you know, generally the Watch Dogs server, and then you guys find the best match on whatever systems are available?
Yeah, that's the idea. We basically do matchmaking through our server, but we'll try and favor friends. That's the core.
Okay, so you can get in there and, you know, stick it to the guy you really want to.
It's more fun when you know
which is your friend. Yeah, absolutely. All right, there's your look at Watch Dogs on our E3 stage show here. Dominic, Jonathan, thank you guys so much for coming on.
Thanks for having us.
The game is looking super great. Definitely one of the most anticipated titles here at E3 2013. And we've got more to come, folks. Need for Speed Rivals is up next after just taking a short break here.